Hello, I'm Dr. Alexandre Amato. I'm professor of vascular surgery of Santo Amaro University, and I'm a lipedema researcher. Today I'll talk about lipedema disease, which is still very much misdiagnosed with obesity and lymphedema. Unlike obesity and lymphedema, lipedema is associated with pain, tenderness, and easy breathing in affected areas. I must start with a disclosure. I am a surgeon and I do operate patients with lipedema with very good results, but I'm here to talk about a strategy of treating lipedema, which not always includes surgery. First, we must remember that lipedema is a genetic disease, probably a polygenic disease. And no, there is no surgery that can change our DNA. So liposuction cannot be considered a cure for lipedema. Also, lipedema is an inflammatory disease. It worsens with inflammation and it causes inflammation. So this cycle of inflammation worsens the lipedema symptoms. Most of the lipedema symptoms are due to this inflammation. So if we can lower this inflammation, we can improve quality of life. But unfortunately, we cannot use common anti-inflammatory treatments for treating lipedema. There is no good improvement using steroidal medications or other non-steroidal medications. The way I see it, the disease has two very important characteristics that must be tracked. The first one is the fat deposition, and the second is the cyclic inflammatory symptoms. Fat deposition always increase. It could be very slow and take a full lifetime to get noticeable, or it can be very fast. It really depends on how much inflammation the patient has. What really increases the fat deposition speed is the inflammation. If you can stop the inflammation, the fat deposition will go very slow as any other person without lipedema. The inflammation can increase with any acute inflammation. It can increase also with food intake inflammation and with chronic low-grade systemic inflammation. And there are many kinds of different inflammation that can worsen the inflammation symptoms of lipedema. What is interesting is that in inflammatory peaks, the fat deposition speed increases. So I understand the treatment as a three-phase treatment. The first phase is lowering inflammation. This can be achieved with proper medication, with lifestyle changes and dieting consciousness. It is possible and it is feasible, but there is no copy and paste solution for every woman. I see in my practice, we can achieve a 35% of symptoms improvement with clinical treatment only in the first month. The second phase is self-awareness. As soon as the woman understands what causes the inflammation in her body and she removes this from her life, the inflammation goes lower and there are no more peaks, and the fat deposition gets slower too. And only then the third phase of the treatment can be done. That's the fat volume reduction. It can be achieved with proper dieting and exercising, but you probably have been told that dieting and exercising does not work for lipedema. That's not entirely true. It does not work if you are inflamed. If you are not inflamed, many strategies focused on lipedema can work. As I said, I'm a surgeon talking about non-surgical treatment of lipedema. Why, you should ask? There are four main reasons. At first, operating a woman without inflammation, we get a very easier intra and post-operative control with outstanding results. And second, because it works, safety rules. It's much easier and safer to remove a lot of fat before clinically without the surgery, and then in the surgery removing only the necessary, then removing a lot of fat in one shot only surgery. Third, Not everyone will have access to liposuction. It is a costly surgery, and for a multitude of problems, not everyone will get one. Fourth, many women complain about cosmetical problems, but it is a mixture of many other symptoms channeled into aesthetical complaints. Lowering inflammation automatically lower many symptoms and lower aesthetical complaints, and also lowers the anxiety associated with lipedema. And we should always remember that mobility comes first. We must treat mobility, and then we must focus on symptoms. Complaints like tenderness, pain, bruises, we must improve them. And at last, but not less important, we must focus on aesthetical results. I thank you for watching this video. If you have any other question, you can ask your vascular surgeon.